Welcome to Basic Science Series. We have detailed presentations on various topics of basic sciences. Science is all about keep learning and keep sharing. This series includes major basic science subjects. If you like the work, please subscribe Basic Science Series YouTube channel. Today, we are going to discuss about pattern recognition receptors. If a pathogen breaches the physical barrier, the innate immune system provides an immediate but non-specific response. The innate response is usually triggered by microbes, which are identified by pattern recognition receptors, in short, PRR. These receptors are our sensor machines, which detect molecules typical for the pathogens. Remember, cells do not have sensory organs like eyes or ears to detect the foreign things. They have sensors that can differentiate between self and non-self. And these sensors are known as PRR, pattern recognition receptors. What PRR sense are the specific part of virus, bacteria, and parasites. These specific parts are called as PAMPs, pathogen-associated molecular patterns. Also, there are DAMPs. These are damage-associated molecular patterns. These are associated with the components of host cells that are released during cell damage. Because a non-functional cell part is also harmful, therefore immune system also detect these DAMPs and clear the DAMPs from our body. PRR sensors are of three types: membrane-bound sensors, cytoplasmic sensors, and inflammasomes. Membrane-bound sensors include receptor kinases, toll-like receptors, C-type lectin receptors. Cytoplasmic PRR includes knot-like receptors and rig-like receptors. The inflammasomes are multi-protein complexes that help to detect PAMPs and DAMPs. Pattern recognition receptors play a crucial role in the proper function of innate immune system. PRR are germline-encoded host sensors which detect molecules typical for the pathogens. They are proteins expressed mainly by cells of the innate immune system, such as dendritic cells, macrophages, monocytes, neutrophils, and epithelial cells. PAMPs include bacterial carbohydrates such as lipopolysaccharide or mannose, nucleic acids such as bacterial or viral DNA, bacterial peptides such as flagellin or microtubules, peptidoglycans, and lipoteichoic acids. PRRs in human medicine. Node 2 has been associated through a loss and gain of function with development of Crohn's disease. Mutations in Node 2 in cooperation with environmental factors lead to the development of chronic inflammation in intestine. Another possible exploitation of PRRs in human medicine is also related to tumor malignancies of intestine. Helicobacter pylori has been shown by studies to significantly correlate with the development of a gastrointestinal tumor. The PRRs are also tightly connected to the proper function of neural networks and tissues, especially because of their involvement in the process of inflammation. I hope the presentation was helpful for you to understand PRR, PAMPs, DAMPs, and the role of these receptors in our immune system. Please stay tuned and do not forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel. Thank you and Namaste.